In recent years, the number of waveform data gathered during seismic acquisitions has increased strongly. Here, you see exemplary recordings from northern Chile. They are just a small extract of a much larger dataset of about 11,000 seismic phase arrivals. Those measurements are used from seismologists for earthquake localization and travel time tomography. To process and handle even millions of phase arrivals, automatic routines have become an important tool. However, quantity is not everything, and especially the automatic determination of wave onsets often lacks of accuracy compared to manual readings. To overcome the discrepancy between accurate onset determinations and fast processing, machine learning algorithms are starting to be utilized. They have transformed image processing and speech recognition, and they are just now starting to be applied in seismology. Necessary for this is the input of large numbers of correctly determined waveform onsets, which are used to train the artificial intelligence of the computer algorithms. Hello and welcome. In this video, you will learn how machine learning algorithms are working in principle and how they are used to determine up to millions of seismic P and S phase arrivals at once. For this purpose, Jack Willem uses convolutional neural networks that are trained with seismic waveforms and already known phase arrival times. Those network architectures are then applied to determine new arrivals. Jack compared his results to conventional methods and showed that neural networks can achieve a better accuracy than those routines. Since the beginning of quantitative seismology in the early 20th century, the determination of phase arrivals, the so-called picking, is a basic task in seismological analysis. For small datasets, this can be done manually. Over recent years, computer processing and storage capabilities strongly improved, resulting in exponential increases in the amount of seismic data collected. These factors render manual picking obsolete and require automatic picker routines for processing. In fact, a very wide range of seismic automatic pickers exist, and these are typically based on manual feature extraction. Those routines extract specific properties of the trace, which are strongly correlated to accurately characterize different seismic phases. These could be properties such as the amplitude, frequency content, or some statistical property. One such manual feature is the so-called STA-LTA. SDA-LTA is the ratio of the short-term average over the long-term average of a seismogram and is typically an accurate, robust indication for a phase arrival. Practically, the seismic energy of the seismic signal over a short-term window is compared to that of a long-term window. Any values of the SDA-LTA ratio above a predefined cutoff threshold are interpreted as a phase arrival. Traditional auto-picking methods using manual feature extraction all suffer from similar limitations in their approach. They often struggle to pick out S phases, as the S phase start time is often hidden within the P wave coder. Also, these methods can contain many parameters that need fine-tuning, as seismic wave propagation is highly heterogeneous and vary significantly with location. Artificial intelligence in the form of machine learning demonstrates promise in overcoming these difficulties. Such algorithms automatically optimize the features most appropriate for classification of seismic phases. This significantly increases the accuracy of S-phase picks, reduces the need for manual fine-tuning, and is much faster than conventional methods. The algorithm employed to characterize phase arrivals is a specific version of a neural network. This class of machine learning algorithms is inspired by biological neural networks, being the basic structure of human and animal brains. An artificial neural network consists of interconnected neurons, which can be trained to recognize specific patterns. This is used, for example, to categorize photos of animals to their actual species. Within this process, neurons receive and process signals and send it to other neurons. The artificial neurons are typically summarized into layers, which perform different kinds of weighted transformations or filters on their inputs. Thus, signals travel from first input layer to others and finally arrive at last output layer. Those transformations extract specific features of the unknown input data that characterize, for example, the appearance of a cat. Artificial neural networks build the framework for these operations. No predefined criteria are fed into the system to decide how the categorization is done. By training the network with large amounts of categorized data, it is able to build its own logic. Such a training with classified data is called supervised learning. The application is a sequential process. At first, the network architecture is derived. It defines how many layers build the neural network and how they process the data. Secondly, the network is trained on a classified dataset. For our example, this means that for each photo of a cat, the correct species is known beforehand. Then, each pixel value will feed into an input neuron. Within the network architecture, the neurons are multiplied with a weight parameter and optimized. This allows to extract input features most appropriate for classification. At this stage, the model architecture is saved, along with the final weights for each neuron. Finally, the trained model can be applied to unknown data. When applied to new data, the weights in the network architecture are fixed and are not allowed to be optimized anymore. A special form of those neural networks are convolutional neural networks, CNNs for short. They use convolution operations in place of other matrix transformations within the layers and are typically applied in the sense of so-called supervised learning algorithms. These convolutions reduce and condense the data until the most appropriate features to characterize an animal are apparent. For this purpose, a feature map is built. A feature map is created by passing a convolutional filter window over the input data and is iteratively optimized through backpropagation. During this, the values in the convolutional filter are being iterated until the error in the CNN prediction is at a minimum when compared against the true classification of the data. If trained correctly, the convolutional filters should therefore be extracting the most appropriate local features from the input data to characterize the picture of the cat. This and other components are used to build the neural network. Repeated convolutional layers enable the network to perform a more abstract model of decision-making or detect more complex features. Pooling operations and other regularization parameters reduce the overall dimensionality of the model. Thus, they reduce the redundant components of the feature maps not associated with classification. Provided with enough examples and trained sufficiently, the algorithm should now be able to detect new photos of cats or other animals. Those concepts can directly be applied to seismic phase determination. At first, the neural network is trained with manually picked phase arrivals. Then, the convolutional filters are iteratively optimized until they extract the most appropriate features to characterize the different phases. Jack Willem and his colleagues tested a trained CNN against common STA-LTA using the dataset from northern Chile, partly shown in the beginning. For this purpose, they applied a two-stage approach. Firstly, they used the STA-LTA method to detect the presence of a seismic event. Then, they extracted a window around this event and stored it as a waveform snippet. Secondly, they picked specific arrival times of different seismic P and S phases using STA-LTA and CNN independently. This is the result of the CNN picking. They used each set of picks to perform a 1D relocalization of the seismic events. The more accurate the picks are, the smaller the standard deviations of the travel time residuals are expected to be. The figure shows those standard deviations for the CNN picks on the left and the ones achieved by STA-LTA on the right. The overall residual distribution is broader for the STA-LTA picks and narrower for CNN, especially for the picks of S waves. This indicates that CNN outperforms STA-LTA and exceeds the accuracy of widely used pickers while being orders of magnitude faster than traditional methods. Thus, classified seismological data from earthquake catalogs are a perfect application for supervised learning-based algorithms such as a CNN. In this video, you learned how convolutional neural network CNNs can be applied to pick seismic phase arrivals. Conventional autopickers like STA-LTA methods are typically based on manual feature extraction and often lack for accuracy in determining S-phase arrivals hidden in a P-wave coda. CNNs overcome this problem and are much faster as well. You learned that neural networks consist of interconnected neurons which are grouped into layers. CNNs are a special form of neural networks which use convolutional operations in place of general matrix multiplication within the layers. Those layers are trained to filter and reduce the incoming data to its appropriate features. Once trained, the neural network can be applied to new waveform data to determine phase arrivals. Jack Willem and his colleagues showed that the accuracy of CNN picked arrivals exceed those of automatic picks of feature-based methods like STA-LTA. Their results highlight the promise of such methods in solving seismological problems using large amounts of data, which are more and more available worldwide. Thank you.